All right, so welcome everybody. This is the second module that we're going to do about common conventions in genomics. So by the end of this module, you should know what a reference genome is, what the different ways that you can talk about alleles are, what allele frequency is, and how genotype data is stored and formatted. Sound good? And again, we need to make a point of thanking our sponsor, UCLA Computational Medicine, because they provided money to make these videos and give our lovely undergraduates food. So, important. All right, so let's just quickly review what we talked about last time. So we learned last time that DNA is made up of nucleotides. We learned that it is double-stranded, and that we only need to remember one strand because all of the information of the two strands can be summarized by the top strand since it's complementary. We learned that humans have 23 chromosomes, and as Rob showed us by showing his picture like a million times, humans are diploid and each person has two copies of each chromosome. So there's Ralph's pants, I assume, unless you use random pictures. and each parent contributes one copy of each chromosome. We also learned that some positions in the genome can have variants. So who wants to tell me what position 2 is? Someone has to do it. Or this will be a long video. What?
A SNP.
It's a SNP, that's right. Is there anything else I could call position 2?
A variant.
Yeah. You could also call that a single nucleotide variant. That's not as common. And then some people might call it a mutation, which we discussed in depth. All right, what about position 7? Does anyone know this is a hard one?
Yeah. It's a structural variant.
Yeah, exactly. This is a structural variant, specifically an inversion. What about position 14? Yeah, it's a deletion, which can be considered a structural variant, usually not if it's super short, but an indel is what we would normally call this because it's short. All right, and then we also learned about phasing. So you can phase variants to which copy of the chromosome, also called a haplotype, that they came from. So these ones on the bottom with the pipe are phased because we know that the stuff on the left comes from the mother and the stuff on the right comes from the father. All right, so our first point is, what is this at the top here? It's been here all along, but what is it? And the answer to that question is, it's a reference genome. A reference genome is it's a idea of what a normal organism's genome should look like. So for humans, there's so many different ones, starting with the ones that were done for the Human Genome Project. So NCBI 34, 35, and 36 were all done during the Human Genome Project. And then after the Human Genome Project finished, there was this genetic reference consortium that formed that has a lot of different bodies that participate who did some more reference genomes. So GRCH, H is for human, 37, GRCH, 38. 37 and 38 are pretty much the only ones that are still in use. I did do some work with NCBI 36 the other day, and it was horrible. But yeah, basically, we keep evolving our understanding of what a normal human genome looks like and including more and more sections that we're able to figure out where variants are on the human genome. This is one of my favorite pictures. So this is the Wellcome Collection in London, and they have a printed out version of one of the human reference genomes, which seems like a really huge waste of like trees and stuff. But you can see down here, this is Y and X, and so all of the different chromosomes. Basically, that's what it is. An important thing to note, though, is that reference genomes do not represent the DNA of any one individual. So they're made using a consensus from a bunch of different individuals. So for example, GRCH37 is from 13 anonymous volunteers in Buffalo, New York. So we don't know who they are, but for some reason we decided that they are representative of the human race as a whole, and that's who we map our genomes to when we're doing analysis. That can cause problems, especially because I'm guessing that all of those people were white. So yeah, that causes issues, just be aware of that. But yeah, so basically what they do is they create a haploid version that's the best consensus of all of those individuals. So haploid meaning that they only do one strand, right? And then you use that later. One thing that I forgot to mention is that there are many different locations that you can get each one of these reference genomes from. The popular ones are directly from the Genome Reference Consortium, but also UCSC, University of Santa Cruz, has their own genome browser that has a slightly different version with different naming conventions. And so if you do work with this, you're going to find out it's a pain. You have to make sure that you're using the right versions of the right reference. Don't worry about it too much right now, though. Not necessary for the purpose of this course.